Hello there. Hope you are doing good. It's been some time since our last unit video tutorials. Today I'm going to show you how to convert your computer or a laptop to a software-defined open architecture model using Unit Audio. And then we are going to transmit and receive data or signals with JNS frames. Imagine you are a researcher who is trying to develop algorithms or protocols for underwater communications or networks. Or you might even be an academic faculty who is trying to design a teaching course for your students to teach about underwater communications and networks. One of the first things you might want to consider is to develop your course or the protocols or algorithms using a simulator like the UNIT simulator. But once that's done, before you go out to the field and test, it would be good to test in an easier environment. And that's really where UNIT Audio comes in. So what is UNIT Audio? UNIT Audio is one of the many SDOAMs or Software Defined Open Architecture Modems that is built by UNIT Stack Technologies. It lets you convert your computer with a sound card, speaker and mic or a laptop to an acoustic modem. The transmissions and receptions happen in air instead of water. So let's take a look at how we can use UNIT Audio to transmit and receive using JNS signals. Let's head over to unitstack.net and download the community edition of UNIT. Before that, one of the things to take note is the prerequisites. Once you download it, go to the downloads folder and uncompress it. Then simply take a terminal and go to the folder, and you can simply type /unit/audio. And that should launch a browser window with the web interface to the UNIT Audio. Let's see how we can transmit using UNIT Audio. All you have to do is just type tell and make sure your volumes are high and then transmit. There you go. You can hear the transmission just like any acoustic modem will transmit underwater. Great. You have just transmitted a message using the default setting of UNIT Audio. The physical layer of UNIT Audio typically supports three channels. One is a control, second is the data, and third one is typically configured as JNS. The control channel uses FHBFSK, which is the one that you just heard. It is very close to JNS, but not exactly the same. If you simply type phi and press enter on the shell, that will show you some of the physical layer parameters supported by UNIT Audio. In order to look at the details of control channel, you can type phi in square brackets 1, that is an index parameter, and press enter. And that will show you the details for control channel. Now let's look at some of the parameters of JNS. This time the index is 3. And you type that, you will see the parameters for JNS. One of the first things that you will note is that the parameter JNS is set to false for the control channel, but at the same time for the JNS channel that is set to true. Some of the other major parameters that determines how a channel can be compliant to JNS are the fmin, fstep, hops as defined in the JNS specifications. The value of a threshold is typically set to 0, which means it's disabled. So in order to use JNS reception, we need to enable that. For that, you can type 53.threshold and press enter. It'll show you the value that it is set to 0. And then you can set it to 0.3. At the same time, when we receive in JNS, in order to make sure it doesn't get confused with the other channels, we can disable the other channels by setting the threshold for other channels to 0. We will simply subscribe to the physical layer so that we get notified whenever it receives a JNS frame. And now let me transmit using JNS frame by typing and press enter. There you go. We just completed a successful transmission of a JNS frame. So now I have just transmitted a JNS frame using my laptop. In order to receive this and decode it properly, I am going to need a second laptop. I have already installed UNIT Audio and I have already set up this to transmit and receive JNS frames like I've shown you before. Now I'm going to do the same thing now I did earlier with this laptop and see whether we can receive it on this laptop. You can actually see that RX frame start notification has been done and it detected that it was a JNS frame and it detected the packet. Now, JNS do not specify a cargo or how to transmit the cargo while along with the JNS transmissions. Let me try and transmit one byte of data. For that, I can set Y3.frameLength, which is currently set to 8, to 9. Now, let me try and transmit from this guy. And this time, I will have a data of, let's say, 1. Yep, this guy received it. And let's see whether I can decode the data. NTF, it shows that it has the NTF. And if I say NTF.data, it will show me 1. You have laptop number 1, which is acting as the JNS transmitter, and laptop number 2, which is acting as the JNS receiver. In this video, I have only showed you a glimpse of what is actually possible with Unit Audio and JNS support in it. In case if you didn't know, Unit Audio and Unit Stack Community Edition is completely free for academic, research, and non-commercial applications. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video.